In evolutionary biology, convergent evolution is the process whereby organisms not closely related to each other independently evolve similar traits as a result of having to adapt to similar environments or ecological niches. This is why you can come across certain animals that are not closely related, that have very similar adaptations that help them to survive. An example of convergent evolution can be something as small as a fingertip or a tooth, or it can be the whole shape and build of an animal. In today's video, I will be going through just a few of the most famous examples of convergent evolution, and we'll start off with the dugongs and the whales. The dugong is the only living species in its genus, but it is in the same order as the manatees. They have a very whale-like tail and flippers, yet they are not closely related to whales. Dugongs are more closely related to elephants than they are to other marine mammals, yet they do have a very similar body shape and tail to whales and dolphins. You can see the similarities when you look at a flipper of a whale and a flipper of a dugong, and this just shows us how effective this body shape is for a marine mammal. Next up, we will be taking a look at pronghorns and antelopes. The pronghorn is a very interesting mammal, and it's native to Western and Central North America. When I featured the okapi in a video earlier this year, I mentioned that it was the only member of the giraffe family that wasn't a giraffe. After I published this video, I had so many comments saying that the pronghorn was a member of the giraffe family, but this is simply not the truth. The pronghorn's closest living relatives are the giraffe and the okapi, but the pronghorn is in its own family, and it is the only living member of this family. Even though the pronghorn is related to giraffes and okapis, they do look a lot more like antelopes. These two groups of animals are related, but they are related very distantly. Both behaviourally and morphologically, they are very similar, and they both fill the same ecological niche and they're found in the same biomes. These two groups of animals are masters of grassland ecosystems, and they're found in completely different parts of the world. For our next example of convergent evolution, we will be looking at some body parts, and those body parts are defensive spikes. They can be found on echidnas, hedgehogs, tenrecs, and porcupines, and they have proven to be a very effective way of deterring predators. Most of the animals that have these defensive spikes are small to medium-sized animals, and this means that they are vulnerable to large predators. These spikes offer them protection from these predators, and none of these animals are closely related to each other. They are all in completely different orders, and the fact that they have all evolved defensive spikes just goes to show how effective they are. Strangely, for our next example, we can stick with the echidnas, but we will also be focusing on quite a few other groups of animals. A number of mammals have developed powerful foreclaws and long sticky tongues that allow them to open the homes of social insects. The animals included in this niche are the anteaters, the armadillos, the echidnas, the numbat, the aardvark, the aardwolf, and even the sloth bear. All of these animals are unrelated, but they've come up with the same solution and strategy to get at termites and ants. This shows us how important social insects are to ecosystems all around the world, and many animals from different continents have come up with the same way to get at them. Koalas are very unique and curious animals, and they are the only living members of their family. Their closest living relatives are the wombats, and wombats and koalas live very different lives. Koalas live a mostly arboreal lifestyle, and you could argue that they live very similar lives to some primates. Because of this, they have developed some very similar adaptations, and one of their adaptations they share with us. Koalas have evolved fingerprints, and these fingerprints are indistinguishable from those of non-related primates. These fingerprints help them to hang on to branches and tree trunks, and they also help them to identify the texture of leaves. Many primates also use their fingertips in the same way, but of course, these two groups of animals are not closely related. The next group of animals we will be taking a look at are the river dolphins, and at first you may think that they don't belong on this list. Of course the river dolphins are related to each other, but strangely they're not as closely related as you might think. Amazon river dolphins are actually more closely related to oceanic dolphins than they are to South Asian river dolphins, yet they do look very similar. They have very similar body shapes and very similar hunting techniques, and the same can be said about the extinct Yangtze River Dolphin. The world's river dolphins are all found in completely different ecosystems, and surprisingly, they're not closely related. Having a long, slender snout and using echolocation to find your prey is very effective in murky waters, and it's a very interesting example of convergent evolution. For our next example of convergent evolution, we will be looking to the world's deserts, as our next three groups of animals are masters of this habitat. We will be taking a look at the North American kangaroo rat, the Australian hopping mouse, and the North African and Asian jerboa. These three creatures have developed convergent adaptations for hot desert environments, and these include a small rounded body shape, large hind legs, and long thin tails. They all have a characteristic bipedal hop, and they are all mostly nocturnal, burrowing, and seed-eating. They all fill similar niches in their respective ecosystems, yet of course they are not closely related. A similar example can be seen with kangaroos, wallabies, spring hares, and a group of South American rodents, but of course these creatures are adapted to a different habitat. Our next example of convergent evolution isn't necessarily a body part, but instead it's a system to locate prey and navigate their environment. Microbats, toothed whales, and shrews have all developed sonar-like echolocation systems. These systems are used for orientation, obstacle avoidance, and locating prey, and these systems have all developed independently. Echolocation gives these animals an edge over their competition, and it helps them to take advantage of certain environments that they otherwise wouldn't be able to. One of the most interesting things about this adaptation is that the animals that have it are found all over the world, and they're found in completely different ecosystems and they feed on completely different prey. If you were to look at a tapir and a pig next to each other, you may assume that they're closely related. They both reach a similar size and they have the same body shape, and they both have highly adapted snouts on their faces. Surprisingly, tapirs and pigs are not very closely related at all, as tapirs are odd-toed ungulates, and pigs are even-toed ungulates. Tapirs are more closely related to horses and rhinos than they are to pigs, but they do have a lot in common with them. While we're on the subject of animals that look very similar to each other that aren't closely related, we can take a look at the South American foxes and the true foxes. The South American foxes are a genus of canids, and this genus includes species such as Darwin's fox, the South American grey fox, and the Pampas fox. The true foxes are another genus of canids, and this genus includes species such as the Arctic fox, the red fox, the fennec fox, and the cape fox. The species in these genera almost look identical to each other, yet the South American foxes are not foxes at all. They are more closely related to wolves and jackals than they are to foxes. Yet South American foxes and true foxes live very similar lives to each other, and they share many of the same adaptations. In this video, I have only really scratched the surface of this topic, and am more than happy to make a part 2. If you have any examples that you want me to feature, then let me know down in the comments below. But for now, thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed. If you liked it, please leave a like, and subscribe if you want to see more videos like these. But until next time, goodbye.